It's new stand. Information is power. The current. The news headline. Repentant Boko Haram terrorists allegedly protest over the right to slaughter cows. Based on the latest report by Guardian News, the erstwhile members of the dreaded Boko Haram terrorist group staged a protest on Wednesday with the threat to break loose from the camp as they demanded for the right to slaughter the cows being used to serve them. Meanwhile, upon hearing the protest, the locals of the community immediately armed themselves with the threat to kill any of the region inmates who succeeded in breaking out of the camp. And according to one of the guards of the camp, the residents of the community were always apprehensive that the former terrorists were not truly repentant. Rather, they surrendered to the military in order to escape from the grip of the members of the Islamic State of West African province, ISWAP, who conquered them earlier in the year. It will be recalled that in the war that erupted between two dangerous groups, the Boko Haram faction fell to ISWAP and Abubakar Shekau decided to commit suicide rather than to surrender to the conquerors. Although the aforementioned revolted by the ex-terrorists was contained, three things can be deduced as it stated. For them to surrender to escape from the camp where they are being kept by the government, they prove that the residents of their host community right that are not being sincere converts. Two, another proof of they are not being truly sorry for their past wrongs deeds is they allegedly referring to the Nigerian army and other guards as infidels. According to one of their watchmen, who is known as Gaga, they consider anyone not in their fold as infidels, which is why they want to be allowed to slaughter their cow themselves. They also allegedly quarrel with their guards, whom they openly insult in addition to accuse them of stealing at their wives. Three, it was also disclosed that they had staged a similar protest in September, and one of the Wednesday was the second one. From the foregoing, a lot of security measures need to be put in place at the camp so that the raging former terrorists might not overpower their guards at last. This is more so because if it happens that they overpower their watchmen and residents of the community confront them, massive destruction of lives, property might result. And such tendency will no doubt internationally present the image of Nigeria in a bad light. Buhari was better than Obafemi Awolowo, Nnamdi Azikiwe, Aminu Kano et al. He succeeded in his mission, generating hateful comments against me, but I leave him to God. For we shall all stand before the judgment seat of God to answer for what we have done, including all forms of lies against a fellow man. Our profession or political and ethnic affiliations would no longer matter as a dead. We're talking of Joe Igbokwe before the brief diversion. Yes, this man loves Buhari to beat. He loves Nigeria and he loves his native Igboland. And you know what? That is now a crime in our country. Igbokwe's life has been severely and severally threatened. His family hounded, and on October 3rd this year, his county home in Inewi was set on fire. Igbokwe is a nationalist. His education, primary, secondary, and even university he had in the southeast, but since he got posted for national service in Ogun State in 1985, he had remained in the southwest, identifying with the people, their politics, their way of life, while not repudiating his love for his roots in Inewi and the southeast generally. No wonder he is popularly called Agbalanze, after that Onitsha Cultural Association. When it was not popular for people in the southeast to follow the progressives, Igbokwe threw his hat into the ring. From Alliance for Democracy, AD, to Action Congress of Nigerians, ACN, to All Progressive Congress, APC, he stood to be counted. And if you count committed followers of Buhari today, the Agbalanze is in the number. If there is anything he needs to clarify about government or our principle, Igbokwe never hesitates to get in touch with him. I gave him background information and he is satisfied. When some people from his part of the country began to retreat into ethnic cleavages and wanted the intelligentsia to identify with them,
The special advisor to the Lagos State Governor on Drainage and Water Resources made it clear that he was a nationalist and he stood by his conviction, speaking out against separatism and an attempt to balkanize the country. At the risk of so much, he opted for one Nigeria. Igboku loves Igboland. Yes, don't we all love where we come from? Shouldn't we? We should, we must. Because even be good Nigerians, you have to do so. When strange things began to happen in the southeast, people being decapitated, public buildings being torched, and security agencies being murdered in cold blood, Igboku stood practically against it. Mom was the word from majority of the leaders of the region, but Igboku, the man dies in him, who keeps quiet in the face of tyranny, he spoke out. He kept saying, building bridges across the length and breadth of the country was the only way to go, particularly for Igbo Renaissance. He refused to join those who were retreating into ethnic cocoon and stood for nationalism. It is either Nigeria or nothing. The man earned my deep respect. He stood for what was right, fair and just, for centripetal rather than centrifugal forces in the country. On October 3rd, I was in Ethiopia with Mr. President attending the inauguration of that country prime minister for second time in office when he saw the sad news online. The regal country home of Igboku in Nnewi, where the man often retires for solitude and where he had a vast library, had been set ablaze. Who didn't? You know the answer. Unbridled hatred was on display, and a patriot was paying a heavy sacrifice, a heavy price for his convictions. What that magnificent White House erupted, when that magnificent White House erupted in smoke and fire, it was innocence that was burning. Patriotism was aflame, and the love for motherland was ablaze. Thy glory, O Israel, is slain upon the high places. Gladly, no life was lost, because the attackers couldn't lay their hands on anyone. But great was the loss, and I sorrowed for my brother Joe and his wives. He calls her his crush, Dr. Grace. What happened is what evil speaking does to a country. The lies and hate peddled by evil hearts have germinated, grown, and brought forth evil fruits. You would expect a man who had been hounded, reviled, and attacked by arsonists to return bile for bile, hate for hate, threaten fire and brimstone. But not our Joe. What did he say? We paid the price for good of Igbo land and Nigeria. By the grace of God, we will rescue Igbo land. It is my turn today. Tomorrow it may be the turn of another body. We must take Igbo land back from the killers and arsonists. I say a resounding amen to those prayers. We must take every part of the country from those who mean no good, concocting sorrows and tears and blood.